Hey guys, welcome back to another one of my videos. Today is going to be a shell challenge, and this is actually basically the first YouTube video that I'm actually narrating and talking versus my last video, which was a shell challenge, but that was a little bit different, mostly because it was like an announcement video. So this is like my first build that I'm going to be talking about today. And I definitely stepped out of my comfort zone. This was a shell challenge, and I have seriously been so obsessed with shell challenges lately. So I thought it'd be really cool to do a build in Oasis Springs. I have actually never done one in Oasis Springs before. I know that might sound a little bit weird because this game has been out for the longest time, but I wasn't really somebody who was into these like desert homes at all. So I really wanted to step out my comfort zone, and I thought since the shell itself was pretty small that maybe I could benefit from having a house that's in the desert where people are more likely to stay outside. And I mean, I know this is a real life, but in The Sims, like, it won't, you know, the weather will affect the house build a lot. So I actually am building right now, and I'm deciding to, well, I decided to do the front area, just the dining, or actually I wanted to do the dining and like a little kitchen plus the living room, but the living room was already so small and the kitchen, I didn't want to cram it too much and actually have a little bit more counter space. But yeah, so I'm just placing a lot of the windows right now, and I definitely decided that I wanted to use not that many packs because I am aware that a lot of people don't have packs like myself. Just like 2 years ago, I didn't have very many of the packs, and now I'm almost completely done with my packs. I have, I think, my first pet stuff, spooky stuff, and luxury party stuff, but I'm just holding out on them because I don't really want to spend money on those packs. Like, I could easily just like buy those packs, but I just really don't feel like it. Because luxury party stuff, the build items, which I'm a builder, so it would basically be useless. And my first pet stuff is okay, but I feel like it's just a lot of cast items for like pets, which is fine. But and spooky stuff, I'm not really into Halloween. I mean, that sounds controversial. It's not that I don't like it, but when it comes to The Sims, I don't really celebrate Halloween, so I don't really care about that pack either. But I will be getting the Nifty Knitting stuff pack, so yeah, I'm definitely excited for that one. But yeah, I was just wanting to do some exterior, like, little structures and stuff, and I really wanted to utilize as much of the space as I can, especially with this living room, because as soon as you walk in to this house, the living room is literally like right in your face. And I wanted to do two bathrooms. Now this is kind of weird, but I wanted to have one just with a bath, just like a full bathroom, and then the other one I wanted just to be a half bath by just having a toilet and a sink. But then I really liked using the jungle living, or not jungle living, the jungle adventure and the island living, there we go, packs, because I think that these packs for a desert build was just so amazing and perfect. I feel like they actually go really well together. I don't know, leave in the comments down below if you think so, but I felt like these packs really go together very well, and I just loved how it just really meshed together really well. But I definitely wanted to do a bathroom that had a shower, but and then I thought about it, and I really wanted to clutter up the bathroom a lot, so I decided to add some candles and just do a bath instead, because I think visually it was better to me, I thought. But I mean, it just depends. I mean, you could, if you do download this, you could just easily just swap that out for a shower, but it's just something that I wanted to kind of mess around with. And yeah, so then we moved back to the outside-ish area, and I really just wanted to make this like an extension of the house without it being super, I don't know, out of place and weird, and try to make the front and the back sides of the house like basically feel like you're not going outside at all and you're just like kind of in a regular house. But I definitely liked adding a lot of plants compared to my other builds. I'm usually more like minimalistic, and this one I really wanted to just make the outdoor space so, I don't know, beautiful, I guess, by adding so many plants, because I'm seriously a plant lover. But yeah, so I did want to just put a lot of these vases and plants, but then I also decided to move that so I can make a little bar area, because in my mind I feel like the person who lives here would probably be a super like artistic, outgoing person, and I feel like if they have such a beautiful like backyard and pool and their house isn't very big, they obviously need a lot of space to entertain, you know, the many guests that they will have over at this house. So I just thought that adding a lot of sitting areas and a bar and other things like that would actually make the outside more lively, and to me it basically made more sense to me in a way. And I think this is actually the first build that I've ever used these wall decorations in any type of build. I don't know, usually I don't use much of the wall plants at all. I usually just use the like the palm and the palm tree, or is it a palm tree? I don't know, but I'm just used to using like the regular ones, not really the ones from Jungle Adventure or anything that's a hanging plant. So yeah, now you can see that I am doing the bathroom, which is kind of weird. I know, I don't know. When I did build this, I decided to do a little walkway area and just like an arc with like the tiles by using that archway, because I thought it would be really pretty and I really wanted to keep the theme of the house like blue and orange, because I thought it really went well together. But you could easily swap that out for just a regular door. I just thought it'd be cool, and I really wanted to add some curtains for more decorations in the actual like bedroom and make it super spacious. And I don't know, I just thought that having a door would just be like every other build I've done, so I definitely wanted to do something a little bit different this time. And yeah, so I don't know, let me know in the comments if you guys just dislike that idea, because I thought it was cute, and I know that might be a little weird, but yeah. So this sim, I'm making them like an artistic type of sim that has this like beautiful upstairs like studio that's like the only level, or that is the only room on like basically the second level of the house. And I did a ladder as well because I didn't have much space and I didn't want to waste a lot of space, and I just thought it would be way better with the floor plan. So now I'm doing a lot of the lights, and when it comes to lighting, I feel like one thing that really bothers me about The Sims is that a lot of these lights just don't light up the build very well, ever. And I always have to go back in and use those saucer lights that literally everybody uses. But I'm so glad that they, with the new update, they made these smaller ones. But I recorded this and built this before that update, so I was just using the BB move objects and just sizing them down. And this was actually the very first build, like I said earlier, that was a desert in Oasis Springs and was like a desert home. So this was actually the first time I was using a lot of these like cacti and succulents. And honestly, they are pretty much my favorite. I don't know. I feel like I want to do other type of desert builds in the future because I think this house turned out pretty good. I don't know. Leave me a comment down below if you actually like this build. It's definitely different from the other ones I've done and way more colorful because right now I've been doing a lot of the modern houses. But yeah, if you heard any noises in this video, sorry, I don't have a mic. I'm literally just recording this like on my phone. But yeah, so I hope you guys like my video. Comment down below if you have any requests or anything. Subscribe, watch my last video, and I just want to give a quick shout out to the person who made this shell challenge that I was doing. And yeah, so I hope you guys have a really good day, or had a good day depending on when you are watching this, and I'll see you in my next video.